full-time teacher. She also has two children. And obviously, you are an incredibly busy person now with, of course, your business here. Why did you even decide to become a Pampered Chef consultant, Amy?
For me, this was an opportunity to do something positive for our family's income. As a teacher, the past couple of years, we've been in Michigan having lots of pay cuts and benefit cuts. But I did wonder if I had time to take on something extra on top of all that. Last year in March, my house was hit by a tornado.
Forward and do that. So where did you find your first recruits?
My first recruit was my sister-in-law. and I saw her working 3 jobs, unhappily, and I thought this would maybe give her some relief from that, and I also, after my first month, saw how much I was making more than I had imagined when I signed up, so I knew that there was money there for her to be making and give her relief from that. From there, the majority of the people have been from parties that I've held. I make sure at every party to talk about the opportunity. I share that they need to actually help me on my team since I do work full-time aside from Pampered Chef. I need help conducting the party. I can't conduct all the parties that are requested, so it's very nice to say, oh, and then
such
I have
a problem
these parties where you live that I don't want to drive to.
Oh my gosh. Well, I just love that. I love the fact that you really helped her out. I mean, 3 jobs, that's a lot, and not really liking, you know, all of them. This is a wonderful gift that you have given to her. So I think that's great. I really would love everybody to recruit with that kind of attitude, that it's also just comes very naturally and it was very easy, quite frankly. As a new consultant yourself, how did you support your new team members?
Initially, I was very worried about that, but luckily my director, Kelly Lilly, she eased my mind. She offered to answer questions and help me with their training. She has been an integral part of my success. We teamed up to work with my new consultants. Many times they had questions about things I hadn't even yet encountered, so her experience was very important to be able to help them. She's readily available. She's also very open with me as to what she does with her new consultants, so I can kind of follow her lead with that. We've set up Facebook groups for our teams. My consultants can visit hers as well, both of ours, so we get that layer of experience as well. And the nice thing about that, especially when now that school started up again, oftentimes they have questions that I can't answer right then, and by the time I even see the question, somebody on the team or a colleague has already answered it for them, so it's very helpful. And then with all these new consultants on our team and exciting consultants, it's been a real shot of adrenaline for Colleen's business as well.
Wonderful. It's a win-win for everybody. Thank you, Colleen, for being such a supportive upline. I appreciate that. Right? Well, how do you introduce the Fast Track to Director program to your new team members as you're bringing new consultants in?
I tell them immediately when they sign up about it. I tell them that they get $1,500 free money on top of the pay and the products and the Pampered dollars and all that. I also share that I'll be getting another $500 for a total of $2,000. So just encouraging them to realize that it's possible. I also think it's important to realize that when you are recruiting, you're helping those people you're recruiting, oftentimes way more than it's actually helping yourself. And I think as women, we often feel like we can't do things for ourselves, so maybe that'll help. But you're helping other people too.
Yes, exactly. And then it's just such a, again, wonderful, you know, way to think about it. And it's such a gift. So, well, your consultant, Bridget Corey, of course, really listen to your advice and to your encouragement, and of course about the Fast Track program. You got her pretty excited about it because she attained Fast Track to Director. So let's invite out Bridget to join us. Bridget! Today, so that's pretty exciting stuff. I understand that you're also a teacher at the same school with Amy. I know, right? And that both of you live in a pretty tiny town. So do you find that there are any challenges with the fact that both of you are actually at the same school?
Not at all. We do work in the same building, but we actually have a different circle of contacts. We have the opportunity to get together during lunch, though, and talk about Pampered Chef, so it's really nice to have that support really close. We both teach seventh grade, too, so. And we actually have a third person, and maybe a fourth person joining our team from our same building.
Wow. Great.
And I do live in a small town. My town has about 1,300 people. So there is a tendency to think that you know everybody, but I'll get in the car and I'll be up driving and I'll see a neighborhood and I'll think, you know, I don't really know anyone that lives there. So if I could just get one party in that neighborhood, it's going to open up the whole block, and then it will really open up my business to a bunch of new contacts.
Yeah, exactly. You know, so many people, as I'm listening to you, sit there and sometimes say, gosh, it's so saturated, or having, I mean, you guys don't even think about that. It's like, just how do I get these wonderful products into the hands of everybody in your town and the opportunities? So it's wonderful. So Bridget, what are you looking for in your Pamper Chef business?
Well, quite honestly, I started because I have an extreme amount of student loan debt. And I wish I would have known about the Pamper Chef opportunity when I was in college, so I wouldn't be in the situation I am today. But after talking with Amy, she would walk by my room and leave it for the weekend, and I have a party and I've made $200. I was like,
everybody. So let's give them a huge round of applause. Thank you.